Let me ask you this, Coach. I know you're, you know, you've been in boxing for many years. I wanted to just kind of touch base on a couple of boxing news, things that are going on today. You know, obviously, moments ago, the recent breaking news of Andy Ruiz versus Anthony Joshua in Saudi Arabia. How are you? Are you surprised as far as the location?
No, because boxing brings surprises every day. I mean, the fight could be in Mexico, in Africa. It doesn't matter where the fight was going to happen. It just goes by. It's a business. It's a business in the sport. Who's going to pay more money? Who's going to make more money? At the end of the day, the promoters are looking at the place where they're looking at their pockets. Where are we going to generate the most money? And I think that's the spot. Anthony Joshua has a big fan base on that side of town. England, Saudi Arabia, because you see his social media stuff, and he has a big fan base on that side. It benefits Anthony Joshua. At the end of the day, boxing is a business, and a lot of people don't realize that. Bringing Anthony Joshua to another victory will generate much more money, revenue, than Andy Ruiz.
Yeah, a potential trilogy.
Exactly. Why? Because Anthony Joshua can go ahead and get back on track and fight Wilder and generate millions and millions of dollars. And Andy Ruiz winning will not generate that amount because he doesn't have the fan base that Anthony Joshua has in England. I was in England at the Wembley Arena when he fought Povetkin.
Russian. Yeah.
I mean, I've never been in a place where so much people in one spot.
Man.
I swear to God, I've never been in a place where I went in there. I was in the arena, and I never thought there was so much people. You could fit so much people in one spot. That's called business of sport. And that was Anthony Joshua's home.
From a trainer standpoint, Coach, you know, if you were training Anthony Joshua, I mean, how would you prepare him for the showdown with Ruiz? I mean, I know a lot of rumors were going around. He suffered a panic attack. You know, he got knocked down in sparring. I mean,
whatever happened, honestly, through my experience, I can tell you this. I mean, I've had fighters in my camp that are getting ready for a fight, and the fight falls through, and they get him another opponent that nobody knows, and he knows it's an easy fight, and they don't even get motivated. There's no motivation. There's a difference. When you have a fighter fighting Pacquiao, they prepare for Pacquiao. And there's a fighters that are preparing for a guy that nobody even knows. It's a different preparation. There's no motivation. There's no excitement in the training. I think Anthony Joshua thought, nah, you know, I mean, whatever it is, I'm just going to get in the ring. I mean, his mind was not mentally prepared for the surprise that he took against a hungry fighter like Andy Ruiz. That's what it was. I mean, I've had fighters that I tell them, man, you're going to fight this guy. And like, really? Like, you know, they get in the ring with like, there is no motivation because beating that guy, I mean, they don't get no credit. You know, it's different. Anthony Joshua preparing for Fury, Wilder, or Andy Ruiz is big. It's a big difference preparation, motivation-wise.
Well, listen, Coach, we appreciate your time, and I know you got, you know, your fighter, and you're here, man. You got to get back to the hotel. But again, we definitely appreciate your time, your knowledge, man, and much respect, and good luck to you, Coach.
Thank you, sir.